Hello, my name is Sherry Bretz. I am an American citizen. I was told at the beginning of the month of May in 2016 to leave my house or people would be murdered. And each day since then, someone is destroying my life. They're making me weaker each day. They're assaulting my brain with advanced weapons. Yesterday I was followed by a woman who had on like a black beret and a red in the center. And it seemed like special forces because I looked it up on the internet and tried to match the uniform. But I couldn't quite make out if the red patch and this had any kind of symbol inside it or not. So it could have been anybody, but she was wearing this uniform. And I've been followed by soldiers in my own town and people in skull clothes for a long time, ever since I started putting my work out there and letting it be seen, and people started stealing it and putting it in movies done by very well-known people. I can't really tell you who they are right now, but they said that they're going to drive me insane or kill me, and they're doing both. They're doing both. I don't know if it's just the high-grade military weapons they're using, or if it's somebody mentioned yesterday, poison on the internet. My husband has been suffering too. They told me before they could give you cancer with these weapons, and next thing you know, he's got cancer. But I'm doing this video because it's obvious that they're going to kill me if I don't leave. They told me they want my house. They've told me on more than one occasion to give them my house. And a few years ago, they tried to build a housing development next door to us, and it would have been low housing, and it would have crowded the septic plant, and the septic plant already has so many houses on it, it couldn't have accommodated all these extra houses. So my husband got with the community, and everybody went against it. Well, my husband won, and later his lawyer said, oh, you've made a lot of enemies in Shepherdsville, the high-ups, way high-ups. And it was even in the paper, too, it was mentioned. But my husband had a speed limit sign put on our road to lower the speed limit because there were people dying every year on that dangerous turn. And my husband helped to prevent future accidents because there haven't been any that I know of, not fatal accidents like there were before. People kept ending up on our creek, even before we bought the property. There had been numerous people that had died there. People broke their back and all sorts of other terrible things. But they said my husband made enemies when he defeated the big dogs, because there was supposed to be a lot of people getting money in Shepherdsville off this land deal. Now they're telling me I will die if I do not leave my land. I went to a political function, and I've talked to the mayor and different people, and I've asked them, what can I do? I'm being murdered, and my land is being, so they can steal my property. And they tell me, well, go to the police. And I said, well, I hate to say it, but that's who I expected to protect me. And I've been getting stuff from their site confirming this, see? And one of the local detectives just was met with Donald Trump when he came to town. He was his bodyguard. Before that, he got to meet Prince Charles. And he also got to hang out with the president of Turkey for Muhammad Ali's funeral, and he was the bodyguard for it. So this seems to be really high up, very high up. And I don't know if there's any connection with that and with the torture, but I know for years I took them evidence that this group was stalking me. And now they're telling me that if my stepson, who I hadn't seen in 10 years, was flown to Kentucky, and he said he was here on government business. He wouldn't say what. And the day that he was in town, someone was making my garage door go up and down all day by remote. And I've never seen this happen until the times that I know there's military in the vicinity. Who else would have the technology? And people break in freely whenever they like. They can deactivate my alarm system. And this has been ongoing for ages. But now they're telling me, the people that are doing this, go to Russia because we're killing you. Go to Russia. I don't know anybody in Russia. I don't speak Russian. I'm American. I can't get anyone to protect me here. I've tried consulting lawyers, but no one will go against this group. They're afraid. And today, I am just totally numb. And last night, they were burning my head all night long. And it's harder to walk each day because they've already torn my spine, according to MRI. They tell me every night they're going to make me blind. They send me eyeglasses. And I wake up, usually my eyes are blood red. And everything's blurry now. Everything's fuzzy. Everything was perfectly clear before I had an eye exam. But they really are destroying my eyes and making me blind. And I'm just doing this video to see if there's anybody out there who would know of a place, say a promised land, where people that are being murdered and threatened to be institutionalized if they don't give away their assets to these bullies with these untraceable weapons. If you know of any country or lawyer or anyone who's willing to try to save the lives of people like me who are suffering unbearably every day through pain and torture that you cannot imagine, that just hide their wounds because you cannot see the damage that these weapons do. And each day I question if I even still have a brain left. And people that know me say they've watched it just vanish. My mind has been destroyed. And then there's this one stalker on the internet that tells me winner takes all, that he's been plotting this all along and that he has the weapons. And he tells me that he's satanic and that he will do me in. And looks like he has a permission slip to do it.